What's going on, guys? Pat at the shop here. I just wanted to do a quick little tech tip about using the thick Lucas tranny stop slip. If you've ever used this stuff before, you're gonna know if you're trying to put it through your dipstick, it is a pain. It's so thick that trying to get down the dipstick tube, it takes forever and it backs up and it's just horrible trying to put it through a funnel. So here's what I do. If you're doing a tranny service and you have the pan off, I'm also not pushing this as a product. I have used it. It does work, but this is not, if your tranny is totally screwed, it's not going to save it, but it does help a tranny that's kind of like borderline, or some people just use it during service and have good luck with it. So, but if you're going to use it, here's a little tech tip. Put it in the pan before you put the pan up. Put it at the bottom of the pan and you'll find that you're gonna wonder why you've never done it like this before. If maybe some guys do it like this, I know every shop that I've done this with, the other mechanics look at me like, that is a great idea, because every mechanic that's used this knows, or do it yourself, or knows the struggle of trying to put this stuff through a dipstick tube, and this is what the way I found is the easiest. Another tip is these GM gaskets. This is like the normal factory gasket. If it's in good shape, reuse it, because you'll find the ones that come in the kits, they're crap. So these steel gaskets, you just, you know, clean it off real good, check it for any sort of debris or nicks in the rubber. But if it's in good shape or just has minimal damage, you can either, some guys put a little silicone, but I find these steel gaskets are the best, or you can get a brand new one from the dealer. But honestly, if it's there, I usually end up reusing it, because they seal better than the one that comes in the kits. So anyway, guys, thanks.